Okay, today I'm with Vasily Khmelnytsky. I would like to welcome to the show. He's been involved with many industries, from media to real estate. He's founded the K Fund, which supports projects related to education and the economy here in Ukraine. Most recently, he's put his energy towards Unit City. It's roughly a $200 million project. It's an innovation park, which the intention, from what I've gathered, is to keep smart young Ukrainian youth in Ukraine instead of moving to my city, San Francisco.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Here we go with Vasily Khmelnytsky.
Yes, and San Francisco and Father Unit City, because we would like to create environments the same in San Francisco.
Yeah.
Because San Francisco and Silicon Valley, all area have environment support new technology, new generation, new startup. It's very interesting.
So what's consuming your time these days? What are you doing with your time?
First of all, I would like to explain my vision.
Okay.
I think Ukraine has a lot of opportunity. Mm-hmm. It's a good location and clever and smart people. And unfortunately, we have very small salary for people.
Mm-hmm. It's
because my opinion is bad situation, because economica can grow if people have good salary and can buy other things in this sense to start manufacture.
Sure.
Step by step.
Sure.
But right now we have this situation. I need to use and I need to start to attract investor, real investor.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, you need to have creative environment. Environment first of all.
Sure.
Because people would like to think about profit. The investor don't like have corruption, don't like have risky. We need to understand.
So with corruption, how do you... It's epidemic in the Ukrainian system. There's high levels of corruption. And we just did an episode of our show out at Yanukovych's old home, Medjugorje. And then we showed also your institution, Unit City. And basically what I was trying to do is show the two directions the country can go. It can go that way, or it can go this creative way that actually gives the youth something to stay in Ukraine for. So from the outside, it looks like we're at a point where it can go either way. What are your thoughts on that? Do you think there's more 5-10 years Ukraine can really, really create an environment where the young people want to stay here?
I would like to explain you, because I lived in Soviet Union.
Okay.
Usually we didn't have business education, we didn't have entrepreneur education. We hated all people who organize business and have fortune.
You hated that?
Yeah, unfortunately. We inherited these skills right now.
So you were taught in school to hate business, free enterprise.
But now situation a little changed, but a little. A little.
Okay.
It's not, because in Kyiv, not one place in Ukraine. We have a lot of different areas.
Mm-hmm.
In this area, for example, the school now implement a program maybe 20 years ago, maybe 30 years ago. It's not very modern program, because we need to have environment for young people. But If you went to unit, you need to see university, unit factory. We create new generation, new people.
Sure.
These people think other way. We start to work together with team. We start to work, create problem and help other partner. And after this university, I would like to create special small startup.
Mm-hmm.
Where people can meet each other.
Mm-hmm.
And for example, you mean startup?
Mm-hmm.
Because you have, for example, agriculture business.
Sure,
I have shopping center mm-hmm. business. We meet in cafe and look for new opportunity, mm-hmm. and we have business future. We start new business,
mm-hmm.
and maybe this business in 2 years, in 5 years, will be very huge in success.
Sure.
My main idea to organize this environment and support this small team to be successful.
So why not? Okay. Firstly, why are you doing this?
What my opinion? Because I very often travel to other country, mm-hmm. and every time study in, for example, every year we went to Stanford and study mm-hmm. one week, not mm-hmm. only university, mm-hmm. and study in other company. But last time we went to Google and Cisco and mm-hmm. Little company. Is this company teach me new mm-hmm. new approach, new idea? Now I deeply understand I can be successful if people be successful.
Right, right.
You need to organize special approach where people can earn more and more money. Mm-hmm. And after this, if people become rich, start to buy flat from me, my factory, mm-hmm. maybe mm-hmm. medical from my factory.
Sure, sure, sure.
Maybe in my friend manufacture shoes.
Yeah.
You need to organize special approach where people can be rich.
Okay, so you're a wealthy man here in Ukraine, right? You're a rich guy?
I don't know right now, because if I look newspaper and maybe magazine Forbes and a lot of rich people, but... Okay.
But you, to the average,
of course, this magazine don't know real situation because
yeah.
in Fortune,
they don't know what's legal and what's not. No
loan.
Yeah, yeah.
It's very possible. Maybe these people went to bankrupt 10 years ago.
Yeah. So, but you could, okay, a lot of the wealthy people here, they don't have a great reputation. You could go to London, get some apartments, and live your life. But you're choosing to stay here to build the ecosystem in this country. It's
if I go to London, in 1 week I become bored.
Yes.
Because I like my country, I like my friend, my mm-hmm. mother live here, my son to son live here. I have a lot of friends. And usually I have rule, my friend and my employees, we never complain about life. And never, but very interesting, a lot of my partner go to me and, oh, we have problem in political situation in very bad, and president and premier minister, waste time, spend free time, it's not very effective.
Yeah.
We have special environment. Mm-hmm. Never complain about life, start to work. But right now, it's my vision, my main idea.
Yeah, because I feel like there's two very strong mentalities in this country from the outside. There's that, I can't do anything because of corruption. The country, the roads are terrible, and there's no future, right? And there's some truth to that. There's a lot of corruption, and the roads aren't that good. And then I meet people like you who see the opportunity here, perhaps, in Ukraine. And in that space, there's a huge opportunity here. For example, I have a friend from San Francisco. He moved his operation here, went from 4 people to 50 people in a year,
mm-hmm.
doing amazingly well. And he's found the young people here, if you give them the environment where they can come up, where they make commission, where they make good money, and they can be in a place where they're not just getting shouted at or beat down, that there's a lot of potential with this workforce. But what is the number? What is the salary for one of these developers where you would keep him here instead of going to America or Western Europe? You know, the costs are much less here of living, obviously. But if you pay him, say, $3,000 a month, does he stay here versus go over there? I'm speaking in general, it depends on the person. But what would you like to see it? The salary for a developer, they can make good money here. What would be a goal to shoot for?
It depends on your business, my opinion. But I would like to underline, we have very big problem because very clever and smart people start to move to other country.
Mm-hmm.
It's, my opinion is very bad problem.
Yeah.
Because,
yeah, yeah.
For example, in Poland. Poland give a lot of support. If you organize a company in,
yeah,
Poland, you can take a lot of support for government.
Mm-hmm.
And money and service is, in my opinion, a big problem. But other way, I hope maybe in 3 years and 5 years, this man and woman come back in Ukraine with very good and strong experience.
There's something to come back for.
But we need to show these young people, this company, we start to organize passion condition in Ukraine.
Yeah.
Because salary is important. I agree with you. But plus, in healthcare and service and security, a lot of point. You need to change a lot of point.
And apart from the economic status, Poland to me is like a watered down Ukraine. You understand what I'm saying? It's like you take Ukraine and you put some water in it and it's Poland. It's not as interesting. Maybe like London for you.
Only for example, Poland, because my wife to manage education has school, and she went to forum, education forum in Canada. She told me it's first reason and main concern about how they can attract young, clever people, talent people in Canada, in the United States. That your friend, good Ukraine, good opportunity. Maybe they would like to take a lot of talent to America.
Mm-hmm.
I understand your friend, I understand American people,
mm-hmm.
but I am Ukrainian. I would like to attract talent from America,
yeah,
in Ukraine, because they have opportunities, very interesting to improve situation in Ukraine.
Mm-hmm.
This is my vision.
Well, look, I'm about to do a show on an American guy from San Francisco, a friend of mine, who couldn't find development talent there. So expensive.
Mm-hmm.
It's difficult. He moved to Ukraine, to Kyiv, a year and a half ago. He has a team of 12 people now.
Mm-hmm.
So from California, San Francisco, came to Ukraine to realize his dream.
Mm-hmm.
Now, a lot of it has to do with economics, supply and demand. He could find his coders here. He's bootstrapping. So that is happening, and action is everything. Words are nothing. Action is everything. The fact that people are actually moving to Ukraine. I'm here right now because I see opportunities. Other friends are moving. That shows something, because, yes, the greatest thing about...
It's a good trend.
It's a good trend, yeah. Good. And I think it will continue. But the thing which is missing, I find here, Silicon Valley isn't just buildings and companies. It's a mentality. And that's the mentality of wanting to invest in startup space is a different mentality, because it's a risk, high risk, conceptual reality in mindset. So if you get Unit City, you do have Unit City going. And what I've seen the plans to be, it's amazing. It's going to be massive. How do you create... Now, that's one side of things. You have the development here. How do you create it so these people can get their product to market and so they can get investment here?
Yes, it's very important. We have a lot of company who outsource program. Yes. For example, I think it's raw material to other country. Да?
Yeah,
we need
to
organize special environment for create product is very important.
Mm-hmm.
Is this product need to registrate in Ukraine? If you would like to think about unit, unit special area where if you have idea, you need to go to unit and look for other people and student and company,
mm-hmm.
and together create new product.
Mm-hmm.
But next step, you create product. Next step, you need to attract a fund to mm-hmm. invest money.
Yeah.
It's a little problem. But
so that's probably the biggest challenge.
Yes, because every time we need to add two things, and fund and members and people who understand deeply in this product and can teach small company and share opinion and share experience is very important.
So with that said, Ukraine has a big image problem in the world, unfortunately. Unfortunately, the world sees war, bad politics, bad economics. This is the news that gets exported.
I know this problem, but I don't want. I would like to scold about the political and the government. I would like to see about future and maybe improve situation.
So what I mean by that is, in a way, it's a secret right now. Ukraine is a secret because its image is really bad in the world, unfortunately. Just like if you ask a Ukrainian, what's Colombia like? They're going to say drugs, war, problems. Colombia's done this in the last 10 years, big time. So it's got an image problem, Ukraine. To get bigger investment, to get bigger names here, what do you think the country can do to get the word out? Look, this place is not at war here. Kyiv's a beautiful city. It's safe. It's nice.
I know this problem. I don't want to complain about this problem, but I give you other example. Okay. For example, Jewish country.
Mm-hmm.
I very often go to Israel because it's very interesting. Israel has very huge new technology opportunity and a lot of it. But they every time to have war. Every time to military, but they separate this problem. If you investor, oh please go to Israel. We have a lot of opportunity. Government support you, please.
Yeah.
And political, we go to Europe. Да, please. We have war. Please support my country because we have problem. It's different. Ukraine combines these things. And every time a government official man go to investor. And start, we have war, a lot of people die. Investors don't like this news, unfortunately.
No.
It's because investor would like the opportunity and don't have risk. It's very important. And criminal problem.
Sure.
Investor don't want to have this criminal problem and corruption. It's a disaster. What my company, we create space, maybe environment where we don't have corruption, don't have criminal problem. Mm-hmm. Because a unit, it's not only my one project. We now I would like to move my company in three way: and unit new technology, and green energy, to wind energy, to solar energy, because it's a world trend. And we know we have problem with atom station in Chernobyl. It's good, good. And third, I create industrial park and special. Place where you can build factory and very quickly because I organize you electricity and maybe gas oil all in place and permission I help you. I would like to organize a special team who will support investor to organize build factory. Factory is good for my country because we create not only profit and people go to work and have good salary and push economic Ukraine in future.
What are your biggest challenges right now? You have these many projects going on. You're forward thinking. You're looking about the future. What's the resistance?
Well, my big challenge and interest rate in bank.
Is what? I'm sorry.
Yes, interest rate. If you would like to have a loan from a bank, you need to pay 10% in dollar and euro, and maybe right now 20% hryvnia. It's, do you understand me? If you European company have 10% profit, it's you are happy. Yeah. I need to pay 10% only bank. It's a big challenge for, not for me, at all Ukraine market.
Let's think here. Few years in the future, what would you want to tell Americans about what's going on here? How will you entice the investors? How will you entice the brains, the startup mentality, the founders, to see, hey, Ukraine's a good opportunity right now. Maybe I'm going to go explore that. What would you have to say to that?
No, America, if you go to America, you need to spend a lot of time because America very...
Far.
I can see maybe in future in Europe. First of all, we need to change my opinion. First of all, we need to change education. Education is very big problem.
Yeah.
For example, I have with my wife school and principal from Canadian education, mm-hmm. very high level.
Mm-hmm.
And this woman told me, it's a modern world, you need to teach a student to be successful.
Mm-hmm.
It's other approach. Ukraine teach a student to be clever. It's a different way. Because why you need to be clever? Now you can search internet and have a lot of knowledge. Be successful, you need to understand where you can take knowledge and immediately implement in real life.
So what's your definition of success other than knowledge and implementing in real life? Like what would you say is successful?
For example, if I went to school, I think much in physics and chemistry is very important.
Yeah.
And draw and physkultura, it's not very important. It's wrong because draw is creative man. If you draw picture, you creative man. If you care about your body, first of all, in future you'll be very more successful. It's the same, much plus.
So self-betterment too.
Da,
constantly bettering and bettering and refining and refining.
Yes, it's my idea you need to very quickly change and improve education. Because, for example, my teacher, who teach me, now work in school too. In maybe 77, as I glad, I proud because I went to the school. But we need to implement new approach to teach today's students.
Mm-hmm. So, what do you want your legacy to be?
I have a family from a small region, Cherkasy.
Mm-hmm.
Cherkasy, maybe 20 kilometers from Kyiv. My father and mother born in small village. And unfortunately, my father died, mother living in Kyiv. Every week I go to my mother and have lunch because I respect my mother.
Mm-hmm.
But all my family from Ukraine. But I born in Kazakhstan because mm-hmm. my family wouldn't like to earn a little money and go to Kazakhstan mm-hmm. work and maybe earn a little money. But in 2 years come back mm-hmm. in my father and mother work and live in small city in Cherkasy region.
Mm-hmm.
My father was a tractor driver. Tractor. And mother go to work and was a simple worker in construction. I start work maybe 16 years, because when I have a summer vacation in mm-hmm. school, I went to work in factory and earn a little money.
So you weren't born into money. You started here from hard manual work.
I start my business, for example, from St. Petersburg, because after army, I spent 2 years in army. I went to St. Petersburg and work as a simple worker in construction.
Mm-hmm.
But in 2 years, Soviet Union broke.
Mm-hmm.
And it became new approach go to Soviet Union and start small business.
Mm-hmm.
My first business, I organized cooperative special company to work in big factory, in construct some small, renovate and construct small building. It's my first business. But usually people who live poor, became more successful because we don't have opportunity to
nothing to lose.
Nobody help you. And
right.
Usually, right now, if I have speech student, and you know, unfortunately we are poor.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's good opportunity.
Start.
You need to, good start, because you don't have choice. You need to hard work. I am sure you will be more successful than my child.
Right.
If I go to other country, I buy tickets in airport and live together with my good hotel, my child see. And, oh,
so that's great advice, actually. So for the people that are poor and don't have much, it can actually be an advantage, you're saying. Because you don't have anything to lose. You only have one way to go, right? So for many of the younger Ukrainian people, you're saying the opportunities are there if they want it bad enough.
In Ukraine, we have huge opportunity, huge.
Yeah.
For example, we can manufacture all goods, and these goods will be good quality and cheap because we have raw material, for example, wheat. We have big agriculture area.
Sure.
We can manufacture in good quality in cost very not very high price. And supply this goods in Europe and in Kazakhstan and other Turkey. If you creative man, if you poor man, very important, you can very quickly, it's not tomorrow morning, maybe in 5 years and 10 years, it's quickly.
So it's a mentality.
It's mentality.
That's it. And wanting to work
but
hard.
I recommend all young people need to strive be tomorrow very rich, because you need to have step by step. If you will be 60, you need to be rich. Now you need to take a new project and fail and make decision and new project. You need to
takes time.
Six time.
A lot of young people want things instant, quick.
Of course, all people search YouTube and have project. Tomorrow, please give me money. Tomorrow we will be millionaire.
Yeah, yeah.
Only one approach. You can give money and you be poor.
So from my outside perspective, I see things you don't see. You know and see things I don't see. Like when you go to America, you'll see things about America I cannot see because it's my country, you know, it's in me. But from my outside perspective here, I'm speaking in generalities, there's a lack of leadership. So for the young people, they got a political leadership that's terrible. They have a business leadership that's mostly like, take all, kill everything else. And then you have Babushka, who's great to teach you how to pickle, right? But she's not going to tell you about the world in 2018. So the young people here, I think they need more leaders. What do you think about that?
No, I have other opinion. We have a lot of, I know a lot of company, very successful company, and great people, people. But these people don't like go to politician. I don't like. They would like to make money very gradually. It's understand on risk, understand on corruption position. My opinion, if you American people and have experience, because you understand in America you cannot to have big profit. It might be little. But if you have experience and a little money and good relationship with partner, it's this country for you. This country, because you can implement this knowledge in Ukraine reality, you can very quickly in 5 years, maybe 7, you will very rich man.
Really?
Because we don't have knowledge. It's very big problem. We don't have experience. And first of all, people go to parliament. It's very honest people and young honest people that don't have experience. And try to experiment. It's not very good way.
Right.
If you would like to be minister, you need to work maybe 20 years in simple worker and next in the main charge of department and vice prime minister and maybe premier minister. But right now we can see in people who finish study in university, please come go to minister. It's not successful. My opinion.
Let's get into some practicalities, some how-tos. What advice would you give? What's a first step? Say you're Ukrainian, you're 21 years old, you might have a chance to get to America or Europe, or you might start your life here. What steps should they take? Say they don't have much money, they don't have many resources. How do they start? Because look, if their mom's telling them corruption, dad's telling them corruption, they're living out in Vishneve, and they're not surrounded by this environment you're creating, how do they start?
I can give advice, maybe young entrepreneur, because I am a businessman.
Yeah.
I would like to describe situation in Ukraine. If you small entrepreneur, you don't have very big corruption, because usually if you big and middle
small means like what, under $1 million in revenue, or what is
million is big entrepreneur in Ukraine. For example, a lot of my student ask me how is I can start business. For example, if you would like to start organize restaurant and cafe, it's my opinion, you need to go work in McDonald's.
See the systems.
During 1 year. And maybe if you will be happy, it's not very simple. And maybe 6 months simple and manage department, you need to deeply understand in process in the restaurant. It's not very simple idea to organize a restaurant.
Restaurants are the nightmare business too. Nightmare. Unless you love it. If you love it, then you got to do it. But other than that, it's you're dealing with perishables, food that goes rotten. You're dealing with employees. You're dealing with low profit margins. It's very difficult.
Very difficult. No, you need to build a company, organized company who would like to manufacture shoes.
Okay.
For example, you need to go work with real factory.
Okay.
You need to have in 1 year, if you understand all process and have experience, you need to look for partner who have this factory have a little market where he supplies this product. In together, you need to have members, because people who understand all process. And maybe this way will be more successful.
So perhaps say you're if you're into shoes, find who's doing shoes in Ukraine, go work for them for free, right? Be an apprentice, right? Do whatever you can for this person. Mm-hmm. Would you suggest this here in Ukraine? I know in America, if you really want to, I mean, the best way, a lot of people aren't going to university now.
Mm-hmm.
They're going, I want to get into shoes. The shoemaker is the best. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go work for him, do whatever for him. And by doing so, you learn more that way than actually learning from a professor that's never really done it.
I would like to give you a good example. Now, maybe 1 year ago, Ukraine Council supply raw material wood to Council supply tree to European. And now a lot of Italian fabric go to bankrupt, because they have a problem with Russia, and Ukraine cancel supply raw material. A lot of European businessmen go to Ukraine and would like to organize factory to manufacture chairs, table. Is good opportunity for Ukraine. That's a good opportunity. If they organize this factory and people go to work and government take loans this factory and they will supply this table and goods to European, it's good opportunity.
Yeah.
Because before we supply only wood and raw material, wood mm-hmm. raw material. It's not very good situation for country.
Okay.
You need to look for this partner and this businessman.
So it seems to me like everything is here.
Mm-hmm.
The people are here. The brains are here. The infrastructure in Kyiv. It's not good.
Bad.
It's not bad. It's not bad. It's not like you're in India or like in most of Asia outside of China. You know what I mean? It's good.
Change mindset.
So what's missing is the mindset, and maybe, I mean, the biggest threat I see is if I have a business, I'm starting to make $1 million, $2 million, and then I get a knock on the door. Somebody says, "Hey, we see you're successful. We're going to start whatever that might be." I don't know. I've never experienced that here. If that can go away, then people will feel free to create, right? And put their energy into something. But if they know that they're going to hit this, then what's the point?
My opinion, people need to feel free and responsible.
Mm-hmm.
Because usually we have a lot of freedom in Ukraine.
Yeah. That's why I love it. It's much freer here
yes,
in the U.S.
But don't want to think about responsibility, because it's very important.
Yeah,
very
yeah.
important. My good example, Singapore. Singapore yeah. have a lot of freedom, but if you would like to throw away gum in football, you need to pay penalty. It's okay.
So this... As the West becomes more restrictive, this part of the world is very refreshing, because you do feel a certain freedom, like more things are possible in a way. It's hard to explain to my friends at home. It's a feeling you get by being here. Mm-hmm. You can't explain it. You can't package it. It's not in an iPhone. But Vasily, I don't want to take all your time. You got to go soon. Two more questions.
No, please.
What would you say to your people, the people of Ukraine?
Mm-hmm.
Something short. It can be anything about life philosophy, about business, about the country. What would you like to say?
First of all, I believe Ukraine is nearest future, maybe for 5-10 years,
mm-hmm.
will be a great country, maybe improve situation, improve economic. You need to a little wait. And not wait. You need to start work
mm-hmm.
and look for new business, your opportunity, your partner,
mm-hmm.
and finish complaining about life. Finish complaining. I fed up this approach because all people like to complain about and demand new future. Not demand. You need to create new future and immediately implement knowledge and go further. And second, you need to keep up with the time
mm-hmm.
because you need to have education from Canadian, from America, from Europe, and attract investors
mm-hmm.
because you need to organize more entrepreneur and more
mm-hmm.
and more.
Mm-hmm.
It's not big business. I am big businessman,
mm-hmm.
but it's not good for country. You need to have a lot of middle businessmen.
Right.
This businessman need to create a new job and mm-hmm. new tax for government. It's my opinion.
And what would you say to the American people?
Every time I would like to teach American people. I want American people to teach me, because, for example, Trump tell every time we need to protect American business,
mm-hmm.
we need to protect American nation.
Yeah.
It's a good idea. They would like to take from China, from other factory, and
mm-hmm.
Support this factory in America. You need to take this approach implement in Ukraine.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And I would like to take American people go to Ukraine.
Okay.
We have a lot of opportunity.
Yeah.
We can help, because it's very important. Not with big money.
Yeah.
Big experience. We need to have knowledge from American people. I think it's good country. Yeah, For example, you first step. Yeah. You come here and show real situation and speak with real businessmen. It's good for Ukraine.
Yeah, I second your comment about Americans should come here. They should come here because once you get over the news that you've seen or whatever, this place is highly impressive. And that's why I stayed. I was going to move to Colombia. I love Colombia. I spent a lot of time there.
Mm-hmm.
The end of the day, the people are smarter here and more inquisitive. And I like there's a certain depth in this culture that cannot be replicated in the US or in the Americas. It's very attractive and it's a feeling. You cannot understand these things until you actually come here. And then when you come here, you realize my life just got a lot freer and there's a lot more different opportunities that open up if you have your eyes open. So thank you, Vasily. I greatly appreciate it.
Thank you for your support. Ukraine nation, Ukraine people, Ukraine businessmen is very important because mm-hmm. people need to understand in real life inside country is more better than mm-hmm. Channel show to all world.
Exactly. And what you're doing here, it's obvious you're an optimistic person and you're a forward thinker. So what you're doing is quite impressive. So congratulations. And
thanks.
Thanks so much, Vasily. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.